Hey guys, what's going on? It's Lewis here, and today is another day for a market update, a new week, a new market update. And in these videos, I basically just scan through as many cryptocurrencies as I can. I go through about 14 or 15 actual cryptos, plus the total market cap, the Bitcoin dominance, the altcoin dominance, and a lot of different things just to sort of get the general sense of the market. What I'm feeling right now is that Bitcoin is at a major resistance at around $14,000, and it's not necessarily the smartest thing in the world to long it, but also it's not necessarily the smartest thing in the world to short it. I took some profit off the table at around this major resistance level, and the other thing is that altcoins, they really, normally what happens is Bitcoin goes up, and then Bitcoin consolidates, and as Bitcoin consolidates, altcoins get pumped because the money that was made on Bitcoin gets moved into altcoins. That hasn't been happening over the past 2 months, and that's sort of concerning, so I'm still waiting for altcoins to turn around and for them to really show some, and literally any sign of reversal and any sign of moving up. Those are for my trades. Of course, for my long-term investments, I'm still averaging into those, and you should always have different accounts for different investment strategies, either a long-term portfolio and a trading portfolio or a few other options. But that's basically the gist of it right now, is that I'm really just waiting until my buy zones, which you'll see in this video, get hit. And the other thing is that, of course, I'm not a financial advisor, and none of this is actually investment advice. I'm really just showing you what I'm doing. This is all practice for me. It helps me understand the markets and helps me understand the different strategies to use. And speaking of that, in this video, there is something that I did find pretty remarkable when it comes into the price action, and that's something called Fibonacci. If you're not aware of Fibonacci, I highly recommend looking up Fibonacci numbers, especially in trading, but there is a golden ratio when it comes to Fibonacci, which is 61.8%. So if something goes from 0 to 100, or from, let's say, like 50 to 100, then it retraces almost all the time 61.8% of the move up. Or if it goes from 100 to, you know, 50, it almost all the time retraces back up to 61.8%. So I found that out, and I demonstrate that in this video. So it's very informative, and I highly recommend you watching at least up to that part, just to get an understanding of what I'm talking about right now. And other than that, I hope this helps to maybe improve your trading, or at least just like show you where the good zones are, like some basic things, so that you could start to understand that there is something to trading and something to the charts, and you can get good, you know, entries and good exits on your positions if you understand technical analysis a little bit. That's why I make these videos, is because I want to show you that I'm doing this. This took me literally 8-9 hours just to get through these coins. It really, from maybe even longer than that. And I put these up, you know, for you to help you out. Hopefully it'll help you with your trading and give you a glimpse into how I like to think about things and how I like to trade. And with that, I think we could just jump right in. So I'm gonna put my screen on your screen, and you'll be able to see the charts and follow along. All right, guys. How's it going? Lewis here, gonna do another market update. As you can see, we are having huge sell-offs across the board. It is a terrible day. It's actually been really bad for crypto. Look at, like, for the last June, July, August. Ever since August, the beginning of September-ish, we've just, you know, 60% down. This is September. 45-50% down. Almost everything is more than 50% down right now. So unfortunately, even some of my long-term holds like Dia is just absolutely getting demolished. So we're gonna go over the market update, and then I'll go over my current trades. I mean, we'll have to see what actually happens, but
But yeah, let's just go over this. I guess the sell-off isn't actually too much of a surprise, given that we are at the big resistance for the total market cap of crypto, and I said expect some sell-off. This was from weeks and weeks ago, and of course it remained the same even last week, so now we're in a new week. Today's date is November 3rd, so from October, we've been saying that I expect the total market cap to continue to move up, consolidate under 400 billion before making higher highs to 460 billion up here, and then come back down. So it's just, to me, it's sort of just a sell-off during the consolidation over here in this area. If we go down to the daily, you can see we're just boom, 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 boom. Let's see what's going on. Monthly, the stock chart size is pretty oversold. The MACD is getting pretty high. The, Look at the weekly. The RSI doesn't look too hot, but can't really say too much about the indicators over here. You can only just say that we're making higher highs, we crashed through the, or busted through this resistance right here, and we sustained it. Then we had the bounce off of this newly formed support level on the weekly, you know, right here, and then we came all the way back up, and now we're at the resistance level. So total market cap is, it's at the resistance, and it's either going to tank all the way, you know, it's going to tank again, or it's going to consolidate over here. I'm still hoping, or I'm still thinking that it's going to consolidate before moving up. That's going to be the game plan. So as soon as it busts through there, we should see a big influx of money into the market, like even more. And that should be really, really good. And that's the total market cap. Then we have the total two, which is everything except for Bitcoin. Last time I said it's consolidating under 38.2, which is what it's doing right here, which is also resistance, support, resistance. It never quite got there. And then resistance, and it's still sort of pounding up against this resistance, so making higher lows, sort of just waiting for it to do something like this, and then eventually come through. So I expect it to move up along with the total market cap. Eventually, we just need it to move up, you know. Let me just move in here. So there was a big sell-off today last couple days because of these two candles. Maybe tomorrow we'll move up again. Moving on to Bitcoin dominance, we can see it's basically in between support and resistance. As Bitcoin dominance falls, Ethereum and altcoins rise. Bitcoin dominance has been rising and Bitcoin has been rising. So once it reaches 53%, I'll put most of my crypto into Bitcoin. When it reaches 70%, I'll put most of my crypto into alts. But as for right now, Bitcoin has been just pretty much dominating everything. Maybe if I... Yeah, I mean, it's... At this, Bitcoin still has a little bit up to go to get to that 70% dominance. So I could see more Bitcoin being bought, but it's just, actually, yeah, I feel like Bitcoin's, I could see it still being bought up, because this is like an indicator. This should have made the price fall, but it's continuing to go up, which is a pretty good buy signal in my opinion. And not only that, but this is a pretty key level right here. It crashed through here, and now it's finally above it. Unless we're doing a cup and handle, but it did push forward today even more. So, yeah, Bitcoin's just continuing to just move. Just move. Moving on to alt dominance. Let me bring this a little bit closer. Moving on to alt dominance. It was above the support. I thought it was looking good back here. But apparently wanted to just crash through it. I was expecting alt dominance to continue to rise and alts continue to rise, but they've just gotten absolutely crushed. So yeah, still no. This was a good place to get into alts. Now it's not. So as far as alts go, it looks like the next support is actually this horizontal at 32.69%. You could see that there's just been a ton of support right here, support and resistance. So this is probably the biggest level right here, and I could see it falling another 6% down to there. So I'm just gonna wait to go super heavy into alts now until it at least reaches that level. And I actually just scrolled out to the monthly time frame, and you could see on on alt dominance, came all the way up, landed at the 61.8, bounced and went up to the 38.2, and then crashed. Almost always happens. And that this level right here will most likely be hit again. So this is where I'm going to be going most heavy in alts. This I'll start going medium into alts, but it's still the best time is definitely down here. Okay guys, so I paused it for quite a while and I just looked at this, and it's sort of amazing what I've been seeing. So if you are watching this video right now, you're gonna get a lot of really good information that could help you, especially if you're into Fibonacci or you wanna learn more about trading and stuff. Because I mean, look at these things that I just noticed. Starting from the very top, starting from the total market cap, it reached $761 billion up here, and then it fell all the way down to $91 billion, right? So $761 billion down to under $100 billion. That's a loss of over $600 billion, right? And so, you know, once it did that, that was the bottom. That was the 200 weekly moving average, right? And then what happened is it came back up, and it came all the way up, and it hit this 38.2. So from the top to the bottom, it came all the way back up and hit the 38.2% Fibonacci. This is the yellow arrow number one, right? Then it started to sell off again, and it sold off again, and it went all the way down to the 61.8. So if I zoom in over here and do this, you could see, if I make it a little bit clearer, you could see it hit the 38.2 right here, right? And then it came all the way back down, and going from the bottom to the top, it came all the way back down and hit the 61.8. Okay, and then it reversed from 61.8. And it reversed from the 61.8. And it moved up again to just below the 38.2 one more time. Then it reversed down again, and it dropped because of the COVID, right? Dropped all the way because of COVID. And what happened is it came all the way down because of COVID, and then it started to come all the way back up again, and it stopped at the 50%, which is right up here. But like, it's on its way back up to the 61.8, right? And that's here. That's the total market cap, right? Look at the total now. So it consolidated on it went all the way up and then it came all the way back down. And this is excluding Bitcoin. So total market cap excluding Bitcoin. It came all the way up to 38.2 and then reversed back down. Came all the way back up to the 23.6, reversed back down. 23.6, consolidated, busted up back to 38.2, came back down. And now it's consolidating. So this is where, you know, it seems to be going either here or back down here. Then there's Bitcoin dominance. And this one's pretty crazy. So Bitcoin dominance, it fell from 97% all the way down to around 35%, right? It bounced up to the 38.2, which is right here. And if I do this, then you could see this is the Fibonacci from the top to the bottom, right? And this is 38.2, boom, it came up to 38.2. Then if you take the Fibonacci from the bottom to the top, it came back down to right here, which is then 38.2%. Which is, it's a little hard to see, but it's right there, 38.2. That's from the bottom to the top. And then right there, that's 38.2%. Then it reversed again, and it came all the way back up here, which is the 61.8%, as you can see right there from the original top to the bottom, 61.8%. So technically, you could say that it simply fell all the way down here and then reversed all the way back up to the 61.8%, right? And then it fell, and now market cap Bitcoin dominance fell all the way back down from the bottom to the top, 38.2%. And it's just like, now it's all the way back up. So these numbers, 38.2, 61.8, these are so important. Let's look at the Bitcoin dominance. Altcoin dominance. So it went from 3.79 to 63, basically up to 63. It came back down, and this was the 200-day weekly moving average, but it was also the 61.8%. So it fell down to the 61.8%. And then what happened? It bounced up to the 38.2% right here. So came up, came down, bounced off the 61.8, and then came back up again, and from top to the bottom, 38.2. Which is also the 38.2% of the move up. And then it fell back down again. So now it's looking like it's on its way back down. A lot of times it comes back down to the 61.8. So this is not really looking too good for alts, because it's most of the times it comes back down to the 61.8. So, and sometimes it even comes down here and then drops, and then, you know, if it doesn't hold, it drops. So this is where I'm going to be going into most heavy into alts. It's like right over here. You could also put in a Fibonacci from the bottom to the top and then get in at the 61.8 of that, which is right here. So this is the other level to, like, you know, start looking into alts right here once it gets into this zone. But like, yeah, these are the magnets. It's being magnetized towards these two levels. And then there's others. So everything except for, all the other coins. And it went from, you know, basically 0.65 up to like 12%, right? It retraced 61.8%. Look, 61.8%. And then it came all the way back up to the top. And then it retraced again to the 61.8%. And then it came all the way back up to the top. Like, these numbers are so crucial. And now it's coming back down again. So probably 61.8%, right? Maybe this level, you know, or maybe this level. This does have the support of the 200 weekly moving average, which is really important. But that's the others. And then there's Bitcoin, you know, and Bitcoin, you know, it went all the way up to almost 20,000 and then it crashed all the way down to 3,100, right? Well, what happened? It came all the way up to the 61.8%. Like, I'm telling you, these numbers, these Fibonacci numbers are incredible. And I have like a huge, huge, like hour long, you know, thing in my course with it. But like, research Fibonacci, 61.8% came all the way back up here. And then it crashed again, down 61.8% of the move up. So it crashed all the way down here, right? So from 61.8% from here to here is $7,000, right around there. So 61.8%, and then bounced up to 38.2. And then obviously COVID happened. No one really expected that. And now it's all the way back up at the 61.8%. It's at a heavy resistance. So it's like, you know, it could go up, it could go down. It's looking like it'll go up, but technically speaking, we are at the 61.8%. We are at the monthly resistance. It's really bad. So I'm expecting it to sell off. Like the probability wise, it has a much greater chance of selling off. And so that is what I just discovered, which is like, I mean, it's amazing to me. It's utterly incredible to see this Fibonacci play out like this. And that's why I use Fibonacci's. Moving on to Ethereum, I think it'll continue to move up to the 500 region, 500, 515, because that's the 38.2, and it's close to the 61.8. And it didn't quite reach it, so once it gets to around 490 again, that's what I'm going to sell. I'm not going to buy anything right now, but if it comes to this support or this support, then I'll buy some if it comes down to one of these two supports. And obviously if it comes down here, then I'll buy much more. I still average into Ethereum every week, but like if it comes down here, I'll put on some trades. When it comes to Ethereum versus Bitcoin, just like last week, there's no clear signal with this chart to buy anything, but once it gets down to this level, this is a pretty major support. Bounce, right? And so I'll go in here for a trade. And then, of course, if it comes down here, I'll have to grab up a lot of Ethereum. So that's basically Ethereum. When it comes to XRP, just like last week, it's in between the major support and the major resistance. You know, support, resistance, right? So it's in between these two levels, so that's a no-go for Ethereum for me. I mean, for Ripple or XRP for me, no buy zone. When it comes to XRP versus Bitcoin, XRP against Bitcoin looks absolutely horrendous, just like last week. So let me update this. November 3, right? Excuse me. Boom, boom. And I still hold a lot of XRP. You know, I hold it in my crypto.com wallet. I get a lot of interest for it. But I'm not buying any. I'm certainly not buying anymore. It's under the support. It was under here, which isn't good. And then, of course, it, you know, fell, continued to fall. Probably should have just sold it since it was under the support for a while, but whatever. I'm just gonna hold it until it gets down to the support area, and if it gets down here, then you know I'll throw a little bit in here, not too much though, just because XRP has not really performed very well. But fundamentally, I still hold it fundamentally. So if it gets down here, I'll throw a little bit more, and of course, if it goes down in here, then I'll go in pretty heavy for a trade. Okay, so let's go to DOT now, because that's next up on the list, and I really, really, really like DOT, but given the circumstances that we're under right now, and given what it looks like right now, I'm selling 25% of my position, and I'm putting in orders a little bit lower. Obviously, I'm not going to sell 100% of my position, because I really, really like DOT, and if you look at the Bitcoin chart, it'll help explain it. So DOT is a long-term hold for me, long-term hold and trade. I'm actually not stacking in each week. However, I am extremely bullish on DOT. It has really, really good fundamentals. I'm trying to accumulate as much DOT as I can at key levels. I accumulated a lot here, but you know, it came down and lost its support level, so that really wasn't good. And now it just came down again, so it seems to be dumping pretty bad. And it might reach this level now. So because of the just incredibly poor performance it's been having against Bitcoin, even though it's been doing okay consolidating around this level, you know, these levels with Tether, I'm still gonna sell off some here. I mean, I do understand this is minor support level, right? Like support, but it's just underneath of it, and I don't know. I just think that I still have 75%. You know, I'm just selling it right here. So if it goes up 75%, that's great. If it comes down, I'll buy the 25% that I just sold. I'll buy it back down here. That's really my plan for DOT. I don't plan on selling too much of it. Like, if it comes all the way down here, then I'm gonna be doubling down because this is just such a key level. I might even bring this down a little bit further. You know, maybe I'll bring it down to like to the 78.6, maybe just above the 78.6. Of course, I would have to. Yeah, I would. I think that would be a really. This would actually be a better level because it's closer to the 78.6. So I would buy here. This is my double down level. So I'm already in it. You know, I'm already in it. I just sold a little bit right here. Hopefully it'll come down here. I'll buy some more. And then if it comes down here, then I'm just going to wait it out. And if it comes down here, then I'll buy it down here. Because fundamentally, DOT is an incredibly, incredibly, really, really, really good project. I see a really good future for DOT. Okay, moving on to Chainlink. If you take the Fibonacci from the bottom to the top and you go down, you see that it hit the 61.8% and it bounced off of this and it went up to the 38.2 right here before coming back down. So, and if you actually, maybe if you take from here to here and then zoom in a little bit, it hit the 38.2, you know, hit the 61.8 originally of this, bounced up, hit the 38.2 right here, bounced back down and hit the 61.8 right here. And if you go like this, you'll see from the top to the bottom, you'll see that it actually went just above the 38.2. It had some resistance here and then closed above it. But this was still a really, really big resistance point right here. So I probably would have been getting out at around $12. But it came up here and now it's all the way, or it's coming back down. So I'm planning on getting in at $7.31, somewhere around here, because it has this gigantic diagonal support line that you could see right here. It has the 61.8 right here. It has the support right here. And it has the 200-day moving average right here. So there's a lot of reasons. So I put in an order at $7.31 for LINK. For LINK BTC, basically, I'm just waiting for it to get down to this major support. It has two major support levels. This diagonal, right? Actually, this diagonal goes all the way back down here. So diagonal support, you can see it continually got there. And the horizontal support, I've seen this a lot where the price will just go all the way up and it will come all the way down to the diagonal support again. So pretty confident that LINK will touch this one more time. And if it does, then got my alerts set, so I'll get in. That right there was LINK. And like I said, I will be playing the USDT pair, but if it hits this major support line on the Bitcoin pairing, I'm gonna play it. Also, take a look at just the fact that this down here, it's lagging. Like, it instead of going down and then quickly up, like that, when it goes down and quickly up, like here, that's like really healthy. Or when it goes down and quickly up, like sharp moves up, that's really healthy. But when it starts lagging, like starting down here, this was lagging. This is starting to lag a little bit, like go sideways. That's not very healthy. That's like an indicator that things are not going very well for that particular crypto. So that's linked. Let's go to BNB. BNB, pretty obvious. October 27th, hitting the monthly close resistance, too close to resistance to get in. Yeah, I mean, it hit the monthly close resistance, too close to resistance to get in, and, you know, it fell. What do you know? So, same thing. November 3rd, 2020, hit the monthly resistance. On its way back down. Down to support. 3. Get in on the supports. Boom. Very, very easy. Super easy to understand. Just Fibonacci, bottom, top, 61.8 is right there. So bring this down here. Bring this right there. Unless you want to count from here to here, then the 61.8 is right there. But I'm going to take this. I'm going to do that. Instead, I'm going to take from the actual bottom. I'm going to do from the wick, wick to wick. And we did daily. Yeah, wick to wick on the daily for sure. Let me do this. Boom. 61.8 is right there. So let me bring this up a little bit. And this is the 61.8 on the way from top, from bottom to top, 61.8, boom, went up, right, to 38.2. That's what we're looking for. So bottom, is this the bottom? No, this is the bottom. There you go. Let me get this right. Bottom, top. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I could see that being 5 waves up. And then 61.8 is right. It's right there. Get in at the 61.8. Get out here. I'm going to say it's going to do this. Boom. 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 That is what I think is going to happen. So. I'm going to put in a thing here. Let me pause this. On to the Bitcoin pairing for Binance Coin. This is a major support, right? But I'm just going to wait for the USDT pairing to hit here because it's just so much further down. 36% versus only 10%. And so I'm going to wait for the USDT pairing to hit because I think the probability of it bouncing from the USDT side is just so much better. And then there's Crow, CRO. It's a solid coin. It has a good backing to it. Really good rewards. It's been been in downstream after that 500%, you know, bullish ridiculousness, right? So I was expecting it to jump up from these levels, but it really didn't. So I was in a trade. I'm getting out. I got out at break even. So getting out at break even for Crow. And if it comes down here to this ideal buy zone, then I'll get it down here. The odd thing about Crow is that this is 76 cents calculated by tradingview, but it's 7 cents, 0.077. Calculated by TradingView, but it's 10 cents on KuCoin. So I'm just going to wait because, it's all the way down here. It's forming a bearish formation as well, you know. So I'm just going to wait until it reaches around 5. In fact, I should probably put that here, you know, good buying opportunity at 5.1 right there. That's where I'll buy, you know, if it reaches there. Then Crow BTC on the Bitcoin pairing, same thing happened. I got in right here, but it crashed further, so was no good. So now I'm just going to wait until entry 2 hits, and if entry 2 hits, then we'll be good. On to Uni. So Uni, on it's just too new to do any actual technical analysis. Even if I go down to the 4-hour, still way too new to do any real technical analysis on Uni. But I grab my thing. Where'd it go? Here it is. It's all the way up here. Get down here. So let me bring this here. Boom, boom, boom. Okay, so you basically really have to go on the fundamentals. I do like the fundamentals of Uni. I think Uniswap is the best exchange, decentralized exchange. Coinbase has Uni. All these other places have Uni. So Uni fundamentally I think is really good. I'm just not going to allocate my funds towards it because I would rather allocate my funds towards other cryptocurrencies. But if it reaches this favorable zone, this will be a good right here, good level to try for a trade. This right here, this rectangle has become a resistance now. So I need to change this, And this is, I guess you could say that that's also a resistance right here. This is, let me do this. Put a square here. Like that. And then I'll change this to, oops, not minus four, minus resistance. And this is the next level to try to jump in. And if you could, you can make a trade here for Uni. If I just do this. But still though, I don't know. I wouldn't even do that. I would say this is the ideal buy. I mean, I'm saying that this is the ideal buy zone. Going here if it reaches this price, especially down here right below this level. All of this is really good buy zones. This is where I would fundamentally buy into a project because the fact that it had this RSI divergence and it didn't pop is just terrible, terrible, terrible news. So Uni, who knows what's going to happen with Uni? It might even go to zero. I don't know, but I got to change this up and put this on November. This is recording, right? Yeah. November 3rd. Excuse me. Only gonna do well after I made the retrace. Waiting for the ideal buy zone. So I'm waiting for the ideal buy zone for Uni. I'm gonna get the 4-hour on here because it makes it easier. Publish this and let me stop my programming. So going on to Uni BTC, same deal. You know, if it hits the 88, this is, might set up for a good trade, but really down here is the ideal buy zones down there. Going on to EWT, I have EWT in here, even though it's a very, very, like, it's a smaller coin and it's brand new. I have EWT because it's my 100x potential coin. And do I have my, yeah. So I wrote down my EWT. This is like something, my long-term investment. I just bought it and it's waiting. It's going to wait a couple of years, 5-10 years, whatever. See what happens with that. Versus Bitcoin, same deal for Energy Web Token. I bought it and that's about it. I'm just gonna hold it. We got Quant, which is my favorite coin ever. Been buying Quant for freaking 2 years, it's all the time buying Quant. I just buy Quant. I sold some Quant though. I did sell some Quant somewhere over here. But I put my buy orders back in, you know, I just keep on putting my buy orders back in. So I got my Quant. If it comes down here, I'm going to buy more. If it comes down here, I'm going to buy more. I just keep on buying it. That's all you got to know for Quant. Same thing, for EWT. So VET. So VET's part of my long-term portfolio. If prices fall, then I usually just buy more. When I sell at major resistances, you know, such as this, and then I buy more. So I'm really just been waiting for this ideal buy zone, because this is the major support, resistance, and then busted through there, and then some support. So I'm gonna put in a sort of a not a too hefty order, but a fairly large position here. And then what I'll do is I'll actually, I don't know if I should buy here or the 78.6. To be honest, the 78.6 is my more ideal. Yeah, this is actually going to be my new. I'm going to get rid of this. I'm going to bring this. I'm just going to bring this down to the 78.6, because at this rate, the fact that it only bounced, it bounced off the 61.8, but it didn't go all the way up to 38.2. That is a little troubling for me. That's very, very bearish in my opinion. So I'm going to get in at this ideal buy zone. So let me just, I transfer my bet to a high interest account and accumulate interest until the price reaches a major resistance. Then I sell. That is for my long-term portfolio. Trade. So buy at the 78.6. 0.0065 and sell at the 61.89582, basically. So that's, I'm gonna just put in a really big order if it comes down here. I mean, it has the potential to come all the way down there, but you know, it's already, if it drops that much, if it drops all the way down here, I mean, that's already a really, that's so significant that I think it'll be worth it for a vet, because just because vet's such a power player, you know. So let me save this real quick. All right, and then vet BTC, I need to update this because this has totally changed. This has totally changed big time. It just crushed through the support level. It didn't totally crush through them, but like, you know, basically crushed through them. So this was the 61.8, maybe down here. It's more accurate. Maybe this was more, this was the most accurate one. So yeah, it's over 100% retrace right now. So this is a level, but I'm not even going to buy it at this level. I just don't want to watch this be the level where it reverses from. But I'm really just not feeling it. I'm just really not feeling the whole market right now. It's way too volatile. It's way too risky is what it is. It's way too risky. So I'm just going to do the whole, actually go on the weekly. Bottom, top, it's 100% retrace is really the ideal place when it comes to being against Bitcoin, you know. So let me get rid of that and. Is this correct? Let me just check, actually. What's the most correct version of this? This would be the most correct version of it, right? So this would be the most correct version. So this right here. Okay, this is gonna be a big resistance. It's hitting the 88%, which is like, it is a pretty key level. I'm not going to lie. It is a key level, but I'm just too, the USD pairs still have a ways down to go. And because the USD pairs still have a ways down to go, I think that the Bitcoin pairs will also fall as well. So I'll buy it down here if it reaches that level down there. So let me get my little... Do I even have a thing on this? I don't think I have a thing on this chart. I need to copy it from this chart. Copy. Paste. Buy at the 100% retrace. That's it. Buy down here. 45. There you go. Yeah, that's all I gotta do for a vet. Okay, let's move on to Dia. And Dia, wow, what a shit show. I lost a lot of money on Dia, not gonna lie, because this was my average entry, right? And then it dropped down. So my stop loss, you know, should be somewhere around there. But I was so confident in Dia that I actually doubled down down here, right? And that brought my that brought my entry a little bit lower. But as you could see, the RSI, it was oversold, it bounced up, and then it came back down and it was oversold again, and it bounced up again and it was oversold again. And it's like, this just doesn't look very healthy to me. This doesn't look like there's really any buying pressure to me. Like, why didn't it bounce? It should have bounced much higher. And now the only way, if this is higher, it'll make sense. It'll be a good buying opportunity if the price falls. That's the only way it'll be a good buying opportunity. So what I'm going to do is simply just, you know, I just sold it over here. I mean, it just made a new low, like a new low. Like, this was the low, lower low, lower low, lower low. Finally higher, and then again lower, and then a newer low, like the lowest low. So I'm like, yo, I gotta get out of this, even though it is a solid project, I believe in it long term. But just looking at the chart, it was just killing me to have my money in there, because it just seems like there's better opportunities. So I took my money out, and hopefully it doesn't rocket, but there'll be plenty of opportunities. So Dia, definitely, even though I bought it, doubled down, tripled down, quadrupled down, had to just capitulate, just because of the market conditions, in terms of Dia and Oracle, DeFi Oracles and stuff like that. But if it goes down to 55 cents, I'm going to buy all of it back up. So I'm going to put my thing right here. I'm going to say buying back my position in Dia, and this is where I'm gonna buy it for my long term hold, right? And I'm just gonna buy it and set it and forget it, basically, because this is a really solid price point to do that. Let's just see if there's some type of Fibonacci level somewhere, from bottom to the top and back to 100%. Back up to just, no, never mind. Let's see here. This was somewhat of a bounce area. Wow, actually, this is really the bounce area. So we got that. How about from the top to the bottom? Not really showing any consistency in terms of price. What it's, oh, there you go. Okay. So from the top to the bottom, 38.2 is right here. Bounced up, hit the 38.2, and then fell back down. So let's see if there's a Fibonacci number that it correlates with really well. Negative 23.8, sort of. But yeah, these two... Oof, not good. Not really good at all. This is all just Fibonacci stuff. Maybe I could bottom, top, bottom. Did that correlate to anything? Basically, so just doing that, it's all giving me the same 20 cent. Yeah, it looks like it might be going really low. I can't really do anything else with Dia, to be honest. I really just can't do anything with Dia. I'm going to buy back in if it goes lower just because it's fundamentally a good project. And that's all I can really say about it, to be honest. Let me just put that Fibonacci back up here, though, because that was actually really good. So from the top to the bottom, 38.2. So that's a good Fibonacci. Maybe there'll be another. Let's see if there's another Fibonacci from the top to the bottom. Just under 38.2. So I don't know if you could really count that. So let me do this. Publish this. Okay. Okay, what's going on? I want to add an alert. There you go. Great. So there you go. I got my alert set on my on Dia. Really unfortunate. Really unfortunate that that happened, Dia. So if you look at SXP, you could see that versus Bitcoin, it literally fell below the lowest level. So I'm not going to be buying any SXP now. I bought enough for the card. I'm going to use the card. I'm going to just stake that for, you know, 6 months or however long you need to stake it for. But yeah, I'm not going to buy any more until the USD price comes down to 16, 17 cents because the Bitcoin BTC pairing is just so bad. So that's SXP. Then there's a ZRX. Let's see if I have ZRX up here. November 3rd. It looks like it may have formed a gigantic head and shoulders, but it have a stop in place because there's a potential to drop to the IBZ. Yep. So it dropped. Looking to start loading up around the ideal buy zone. That's really all you could say. USD right around here, mostly in. Mostly. So yeah, we got that. Nothing more to really say about ZRX. ZRX versus Bitcoin. I'm, you know, just waiting for it to reach this ideal buy zone and then it'll be good. And that's going to do it for this market update. We got all the way through ZRX and that's, you know, nearly 30 or nearly 15 coins up against both USDT and BTC values. So I'm going to go through the rest of these coins for, you know, the group and stuff like that. So I hope that this was helpful and hopefully things play out the way we want them to play out. Other than that, I'll see you in the next video, but be sure to check out the videos in the links in the description because there's a ton of really good videos to watch after this. All right, thanks. See ya.